You're so pretty.
Thank you.
You're so pretty.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
And also, I feel like you are kind of a unicorn to me because I rarely meet somebody who was like from LA.
Yeah.
I understand that you're an LA baby. Is that where the acting bug got you? Like, was it being in LA and around all of it? Or like, how did you get into the field?
I think so. I grew up watching my mom act. My mom did a lot of theater. When I was growing up. And so when the opportunity came for me to get representation, it was like, of course.
Yeah.
You know, I want to be like my mommy. Mm-hmm. And ever since I started, I just fell in love with it. And there's nothing else I'd rather do.
Just off to the races ever since.
Hey, just kept going. And I think I had an amazing childhood because I had a mom who saw that I loved it. Mm-hmm. And then she would see whenever I was exhausted or tired and didn't want to and gave me the option. So I was never forced
to
do it. Yeah.
Were they ever worried about their little bitty baby going into such a complicated, cutthroat profession?
I mean, I think so, but they never showed it. I mean, my mom, my family's crazy. So I think it was like, ain't nobody gonna mess with my baby.
Uh-huh.
That's how I feel, you know? Like, no matter what, the world is... it's crazy. So really, mm-hmm. no matter what you get into, you have to be strong and prepared for it. So at a young age, me knowing that acting was a hobby, and I was very fortunate to do something that I love to do. But just mm-hmm. like everybody else was doing after school stuff, I was going to audition. So, mm-hmm. you know, that was my thing.
What does it feel like auditioning for a part when you are so young? Like, did you have like a good understanding of, like, you know, you're gonna go into this thing and you might not get it, and they mm-hmm. might say you're not enough of this and enough of that. Like, what was that like as a kid?
It wasn't that bad, I think, because my life was still so normal. I was still in regular school, especially at that age.
Mm-hmm.
To me, the fun part was the auditions.
Yeah.
And I wasn't really thinking, are they gonna like me?
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of like, well, I like myself and I think this is fun. And let me see if they like me for this. And then I had other little actress friends that I'd be like, oh, maybe she'll get it. And I think it just helped me growing up because now I look forward to seeing a lot of actresses work.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes people will be like, well, you didn't get that part. Are you mad? I'm like,
yeah.
No.
That's amazing.
It wasn't, I've always looked at things like it wasn't meant for me.
Mm.
It was meant for them. Everybody's on their own journey.
Mm-hmm.
And even if I go through times where I haven't been working, it's kind of like, okay, things are going to happen when they're supposed to.
Uh-huh. I feel like I have spent a lot of time and a lot of therapy to learn these lessons. I'm very impressed.
But no, I feel like in this industry, you have to think like that.
I'm sure.
Because you will go crazy. You cannot hate every beautiful woman that walks past you.
Mm-hmm.
That,
especially in this city.
That girl that mm-hmm. enjoys what you like to do.
Uh-huh.
Of course, I prefer the much nicer women to book
sure.
things. So if I see someone who I know is a genuinely dope person book something, it's just mm-hmm. like, you know, you get excited for other people.
Uh-huh. There are,
you know,
other dope black girls around. And
yes.
I feel like that response says more about like the opportunities that are available for black women. Like, you know, oh, there's only one person in like
yeah.
this movie. Like, are you upset? Because I feel like some people don't know like when there's gonna be another like
yeah.
great role.
But I also think people will keep saying that to try to pin us against each other
for
and
sure.
make us feel like I have to feel challenged mm-hmm. by this person when that's not it at all.
Yeah, and they do that to like up publicity and stuff.
And I look at people whose energy is, and I'm weird because I see people whose energy is off. I'd be like, hi, how you doing? Like, what you doing? Are you reading? Okay, like
uh-huh.
just to like loosen it up.
Yeah,
like,
shake
it's not
up a
so
bit.
Like, let's chill.
Yeah, relax.
Somebody gonna book it.
I love this.
You gonna get your money here, I'll get my money there. We
right.
straight.
And then everybody can eat.
Everybody can eat.
Can eat. Yes, exactly. Well, you've been working and eating for a minute. I'm looking at your resume.
Oh.
So you got Barney's Great Adventure in 98. Mm-hmm. Also 98, Dr. Doolittle with somebody named Eddie Murphy.
You know this little guy.
You know, I mean,
like amazing.
That dude. And you've had the chance to do a lot of fun movies. Like, I am obsessed with animals personally. So Dr. Doolittle's just like right up
my
alley.
I got to a certain age where I was like, look here, don't put me in nothing with a dog. I'm not playing with no more animals. I'm over this. I'm done.
Uh-huh.
And then I did Hotel for Dogs. Then I did, so you never say never.
You're like, well, okay.
And people used to always tell me, they would say, well, they say don't work with animals or children.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, those are the nicest people. Y'all, I don't want to work with grown-ups. They're the ones that's crazy.
Yeah. So back to this incredibly long resume. I feel like this movie in particular is having a moment like right now today. If you get on Twitter, you're going to see somebody talking about Love and basketball. Yeah. Man, you classic. Are in the, in just, in, embedded in Black American history.
Which is forever. Crazy.
What does it feel like?
It feels amazing because I didn't think about it like that. I don't, to this day, I still have people who come to me and they're like, oh my God, I grew up watching this. And I'm like, I had no idea that I was making any type of impact. Mm-hmm. Because I was just a kid who got to do something amazing. And, and I got to work and do all these fun. To me, I was like, oh, I get to go to work today. Mm-hmm. Oh, I get to go to work. I do hair and makeup. Okay, what's my lines? I'm not thinking about shooting one-on-one every week. I was not, mm-hmm. oh, people are going to watch this.
Yeah. We're making history.
Oh, people are watching me on television. Like, it wasn't even, I was like, oh, I got to go to work. We table read on Monday. We shoot on Thursday. Mm-hmm. I got Friday off. Cool. I'm going to go do this with my friends. I'm going to go do this with my family.
Yeah.
I got to go back to work on Monday. Like, it was a job. It was like a fun job that I got to do. So to realize that there's so many people who watched these things that I was blessed enough to be a part of is dope.
Mm-hmm. Aww. Did you ever get starstruck with any of your co-stars? Like, were you of an age to be like, wow, this is a really, really big star?
No, the first time I felt myself get starstruck, I went to go see a Tyler Perry play, and I was in the hallway and Sidney Poitier walked by. And I never knew that I could get starstruck.
Wow.
But I think that triggered something because now I get more starstruck.
Yeah.
Like, I see people, I'm like, oh is God. That Denzel?
Oh, my God.
Oh, mm. Oh, don't tell me you like your movies. That's because it's going to just come out wrong. It's right. going to come out. Don't even say it. Just smile and nod. Oh, hello, hello. How you doing? Ooh. But, I mean, these are people doing the same thing I do.
Yeah.
So I also have to look at them like, I just enjoy their work, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? And if I find the right moment, if I don't feel crazy for saying what I'm about to say, I'll mm-hmm. let them know I enjoy your work.
Yeah. See, my problem is I tend to always do it even when I know I shouldn't. So I end up just being like...
See, the only time I... And people ask me that today. They'll be like, do you get bothered by people coming up to you? And I let people
That's
know...
That's the question.
When I'm eating... That's the only time.
Don't bother me
with
that.
And I'd be like, you breathing on my food.
Look, like, I don't know you like that.
Thank you for the love, but can we talk about this in a
Right.
I mean, I'm still very, you know, pleasant. Mm-hmm. And then now I've made a rule when I'm with my kids, I don't. I speak, but I don't. I try not mm-hmm. to do pictures and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Just because I want my babies to know that they're the most important thing. So I want them to have all my time.
Learning how to set boundaries is really, really hard.
It is. And because for a long time, I was like, well, they love my work. And
I
want to be nice. And what mm-hmm. if they never see me again?
And like, I owe them.
And I was like, oh, my gosh. Like, they, you know, they're so pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
And, but I had to realize, like, my fam, like, that's my... These are the people that's going to miss me when I'm gone. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
These kids, I want them to remember our memories of us spending time together, not mommy constantly being pulled in different directions.
Right.
So
that's I had amazing to. Enemy
and even to this day, I still be feeling bad. I'll be like,
aww.
And if it's a little kid, I'll be like, okay.
Aww.
I'll be like, I'll ask my kid, I'll be like, baby, do you mind if I just.
Aww.
And they're like, no, go ahead, mom. So if it's a kid, I usually like try to mm-hmm. bend it a little bit. But
aww.
But most of the time,
I love this story so much.
Yeah. It's a struggle. It's a struggle.
I can't imagine.
It's a struggle.
Because
people who enjoy my work, I love anybody who shows me love.
Mm-hmm.
And so I want to give it, the, you know? So it's hard, but you got to set boundaries.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I feel like speaking of your work that people love, we cannot have this conversation without talking about the Pratt Family. What?
Crazy.
Destiny's Child sang the theme song.
What?
I cannot believe to this day, like,
in a
it happened
video
yesterday.
Was Destiny's Child.
Oh my gosh.
You know? Back in the day.
have your kids seen the show?
Yes.
Do they
love
like
the
it?
Proud Family.
Aww.
Yeah. And I remember the first time I played it for them, I wanted to see if they recognized my voice, and they did.
Aww.
Yeah.
I've always been interested in, like, doing voiceover work and voice acting. I hear it's really, really, really hard.
Yeah.
Would you say that it's more difficult than acting, or just like?
It has its, well, the pluses for me is I don't have to get dressed. I can just be looking.
Show up with your hair wrapped and your house shoes.
Girl, I mean, not that bad.
Oh, my bad. Me either. I wouldn't
do
that.
I've forced my man to be like, can you not leave the house like this? I was like, what's happening? Why? Can you please put something? hat on. You got a hat?
I'm right. Like, something.
Something. But I can go and I can just chill, you know? I can just relax. And the only thing for me for voiceover is I'm a very loud person. And I have not perfected breathing from my diaphragm. So I tend to lose my voice a lot. Like even now, it's not from yelling. I was actually sick for a little bit. Yeah, I tend to lose my voice a lot. Like, especially when I know I have to do voiceover. Something happens.
I feel like every kid actor's dream, young actor's dream, or hell, even like actor period's dream is to get on a Disney Channel show.
Yeah.
How did that opportunity come to you?
I auditioned. I actually auditioned for the voice of the Proud Family, and it was crazy because they already had her drawn up. And the crazy thing is at that age, I think I was 13. I was 13 or 14. I didn't like my voice. I think I had gotten sick, and then my voice was raspy, and it stayed raspy. And I was like, oh my gosh. And the kids at school were like talk, not bullying. I wasn't bullied, but they were like making fun of my voice and calling me a boy because I went through puberty and I sounded different. And I think I was just always like, oh, my voice. And you, I think everybody who hears their voice back is like, is that me? And I'm like, why don't y'all tell me I sound like this? Like, or don't let me be with family and loud and just like, like yelling for something and somebody's recording. I'm like, oh my goodness. Like, Kyla, just, you have to be more refined. But it never happens. It's just always, I'm just,
I love it though, because I feel like you sound like my cousin. Mine is a little country accent, but I
you
just
know,
feel like,
just a little bit, you just know, a little bit.
Sometimes we lay out. That's that.
But yeah, I auditioned and throughout the process, I was like, they're not gonna like my voice there. I'm gonna, and then I think they replaced one of the characters like in the middle of us shooting. And I was like, she got replaced. They're gonna.
I
don't know. I'm like, just have fun, Kyla. Just kill it. Just have fun. And I just was like, when I decided to not stress over it, because you always get into that age where you start thinking too much.
I was born in that age.
Oh goodness. The crazy thing is I went through those very briefly.
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't like a long period of time where I was just not feeling myself. And I think I went through that later on, like after I had kids, and it was like, What is this feeling? Like, I didn't go through this, so it's coming now.
Insecurity?
What is that?
How did you snap out of those moments?
I find the good in everything. You have to fight off negative feelings because we all have them.
Yeah. And other people have them about you, too. And
other people have them, and I tell people all the time, like, stop. Don't beat up yourself too much because the world is constantly beating on you.
Amen.
So don't, I mean, recognize what you need to work on, but don't beat yourself up, you know? And
being kind to yourself is hard as hell. You need to bottle that. Sell it.
Girl.
I'll test it
for
you.
Where's that? Because I need some. Like, sometimes I'll piss myself off. Like, why are you acting like this? I literally will go in a mirror and be like, and call myself out my name. And be like, you need to get it together. You need,
get it together.
And then I'll be like, all right, you tripping. But then I think now it's important to me because I know my kids are watching me. I'm raising two little girls.
I think that's why the Proud Family resonated with so many different like age groups, because it wasn't just for like my nieces and nephews, you know. I'm at the table watching too, you know. My favorite character was the uncle who sounded like the dude from What's the Word Up, the cameo.
I believe that was Cedric the Entertainer.
I'm surprised like I couldn't just go Google it and see all these years. I did not know that.
We had
amazing.
So many people on there, so many dope people.
It was so black. It was such a black
it was
show.
Hilarious.
It was so black.
And I was like, oh, I get to talk stuff and just yell into the mic
and get paid for it,
you know.
Amazing.
Especially being my age, at that age you're trying to be all respectful all the
time. I know, and reserved. But now you can just go run around,
you know. I can say whatever.
Were you aware that most of like when you were making the show, and I know that it's hard to like see something when you're in it, but like while you were making the show, were you aware that like, wow, this is a show full of like black actors? This is a show about a black family, and that's like really, really big.
I thought it was dope because it was something I could relate to. I don't think I looked too far into it. I just was like, oh, this is cool. They're talking about things that people don't talk about. And I was learning about different things while shooting it. You know, and there's a lot of things that they try to teach you in school, but you like, ugh,
I'm
this
never
is
gonna
school,
use this.
I'm not using this, let me just memorize it for a test that you don't take in. And then there's things that you learn from your family that you like, ugh, my family is driving me crazy, I don't feel like doing this. But when it's something you love and it's being brought to you, then it's easier to take it in, you know? So I just, watching it now, I'm like, I'm so glad there's something like this for my babies to watch. Mm-hmm. You know?
And I'm so glad that it's going to like last. Like that show has longevity. When I saw that meme online that pretty much said that like Beyonce's life has turned into the Proud Family and she got her twins, I was like, oh my gosh.
I'm connected to Beyonce, y'all.
Look what you did to Beyonce. Yeah. Oh. That blew my mind. I was like, wow.
Yeah.
It really, really did happen.
And it's amazing
like
to see that, like, and not even realizing at the time, like, being in the little video and in the booth with Solange and, mm-hmm. and Destiny's Child.
That was
like,
so cute.
But at the time, I'm just like, oh, they sing real nice. Uh-huh. They were so sweet. They're so nice. They're such nice ladies. Like, uh-huh. I'm not thinking, you know, fast forward and all right. the success that, you know, all of them have in their mm-hmm. own way, you know. It's dope.
You got any tea about the Proud Family you can share? Is it coming back?
I don't think I'm supposed to talk about it, but
it's okay.
I think,
nobody, I won't tell nobody.
I think by the time this is airing, I think everybody already's gonna know.
Okay.
So we are doing the Proud Family reboot. Yes, and they're bringing back all the same people.
Oh.
All the same voices. Everybody.
I'm getting emotional. And, I'm really
Yeah, we're bringing it back, Aww. And it's I'm excited for it. Uh-huh. I'm so excited for it. And
I am
Bruce
too.
Smith and Ralph Farquhar, they have been amazing uh-huh. just from the beginning. You know?
They're the ones who are bringing it back?
Yeah, they're bringing it back. But they're the ones that started everything, you know? And
how did I not know that?
And they basically, the first time we shot it, it was like guerrilla style. They were making it happen. Mm-hmm. We weren't up under Disney completely.
Wow.
And now it's like Disney's like, look. Uh-huh. The people talking about this. Mm-hmm. And we said, we've been telling y'all.
See what happens when you let black people make things.
You know?
Like, we know what black folks want. Just listen to us sometimes. Give us some creative control.
Yeah, so I'm excited.